Hey guys, welcome to another Tackle Tip Tuesday with RHINOjoe Outdoors. Hey guys, so today what we're going to be talking about is the three tips that I have if I were to go back in time and start kayak fishing now. So the first tip is going to be make sure that you get a nice kayak that is a sit on top. So a lot of people, you know, they make the mistake of buying whatever kayak they can. When I got my first fishing kayak, I got a sit inside kayak from Bass Pro Shops. Now, I will say that that kayak, it got me out on the water. So that's the most important thing. But it was a sit inside, so it could get really wet inside. It wasn't the best, especially if you're fishing in cold weather. It was extremely stable, which was one nice thing. But you know what? It sparked this obsession that I call kayak fishing for me. So in the end, it was a great kayak. But if I could go back in time, I would have gotten a sit on top kayak. Probably would have gotten something like a Wilderness Systems tarpon or maybe a ride, something like that. Whenever I first started kayak fishing, they didn't really have all the frame seats and all that stuff. The Jackson Kayak Coosa was kind of like one of the first ones to incorporate that. And I, of course, probably would have got that if that kayak would have been out. So the second tip that I have is really invest in a couple good rods and reels. When I first started getting into kayak fishing, when I came back from my second deployment, I kind of got some cheap combos and stuff like that, stuff that really didn't last. So I should have invested a little bit more money and gotten some nicer rods and reels in the beginning that I could really hold on to. At a minimum, I would at least get, you know, at least one probably medium heavy fast action rod with a bait cast reel with like a decent speed to it. And that can be used for, you know, soft plastics, jigs, stuff like that. Definitely get another rod that's probably going to be about a medium to medium heavy moderate action to fish crankbaits and stuff like that. And then last but not least, I would say probably a medium action spinning rod, probably about 7 foot in length. And that's to fish like other finesse presentations on. You know, if you have those three rods, you can at least start out and have a couple different presentations set up to where you can switch in between them and really dial in on the pattern for the fish. All right, so finally, the third tip that I have is get a really nice paddle. So, you know, invest in a really good paddle. More than likely, you are going to keep that paddle even when you sell your first kayak and you buy a second or maybe a third. You're probably still going to keep that same paddle that you initially buy unless you decide to upgrade. But, you know, usually like with most kayaks, like as long as you get a decent length paddle, for most sit-on-tops, you're probably going to keep that paddle. And so invest in a really good paddle. It makes paddling extremely much more effective. It's lighter, higher quality. You know, some of the fishing designs have the little hook thing on them so that you can get your baits off. But, you know, having a great paddle is key to enjoying your time on the water. Alright guys, now I know I only told you I would do three tips, but this is a bonus tip. So bonus tip is to make sure to invest in some good cold weather gear, whether that be a set of waders and a dry top. You know, I know that there are a lot of videos out there. Jeff Little with The Little Stuff and Chad Hoover both have some great videos about cold weather kayak gear. And really, like, the main thing with that is, number one, like, safety while you're on the water. And number two, it keeps you comfortable so you can fish year-round on your kayak. So that would probably be the best bonus tip that I could give you. But what I want to ask you all is my question of the day. So the question of the day today is, what would you all do if you all could go back in time and do something different about whether it's kayak fishing or something else? Like, what would you have done differently when you started fishing? But hey guys, like this video, give it the old thumbs up if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe. And to make sure you don't miss any of my content or any of my videos, go ahead and ring that bell so you don't miss any notifications. And I, as always, guys, thank you guys so much for watching my videos. Make time to get outside and enjoy the outdoors. Maybe think about taking somebody else with you and introduce somebody else to the great outdoors that both you and I love. See you guys in the next video.